And Ocean City will turn purple when Ravens fans from all around take over the town.
The annual Ravens Roost convention runs Thursday through Sunday. 11 News reporter Jennifer Franciotti caught up with the members of Roost number 117 in Catonsville as the fans get ready to head down to the ocean.
On behalf of Ravens Roost 117, I want to thank you.
A check for the Believe in Tomorrow Foundation to help house critically ill children and their families during treatment. Fundraising for the community is half of what the Ravens Roost is all about.
It goes directly to the families that we serve and kind of helps them heal and get through their treatment process and believe in tomorrow.
That's a great part of what we do here. We do get to have a good time and support our team, but the most important part is the charity portion of it.
There are 68 Ravens Roosts throughout the region, a chance for fans to talk football year-round. And this week, the Roosts will gather in one spot, Down the Ocean, an annual convention in Ocean City that dates back to 1964 with the Colts Corrals.
We have horseshoes, tug of war, volleyball tournaments. We have an awesome bull roast on the beach down there on Saturday. And on Saturday morning, we take over Baltimore Avenue with a huge parade. We walk through in our Ravens gears. We have floats. This year's theme is Respect All, Fear None.
I think I would love to go to it.
It's great to see all the fans. You have no idea how many there are until you go down there. All the signs down the ocean are all welcoming the Ravens fans. Everything's purple. There's flags and just purple Ravens everywhere.
I just like going down there and seeing all the other Roosts. I mean, we see each other maybe once a month at a council meeting, but it doesn't compare to the Ravens feel, the purple. We take over.
The Ravens Roost Parade starts at 10 o'clock in Ocean City on Saturday morning. Because of the lockout, the players won't be there this year, but the cheerleaders will be. And hey, they look better in bikinis anyway. In Catonsville, Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.